Dear students, today we are going to discuss the format of note making. Okay, in the examination, a passage or an article is given. On the basis of that passage or article, you are asked to make note. First of all, try to identify what is the passage or article or note. According to your identification, put a suitable title to your note. As I have told you earlier, that your note should be divided into maximum 5 to 6 heading or parts, main parts. So for each part you can use numbers, number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5. Okay, here for example, in the first part you have to write the main point of the heading. Suppose you have to add certain information to clarify the heading, you can use point number 1.1 and note down the subheading. If you need to add more subheading, you can write 1.2, 1.3, 1.4, 1.5 and so on. It may also happen that to clarify the subheading, you have to add certain supporting points that are already given in the passage or article. So you can write like this. Suppose here, in the subheading of 1.2, the student has to supply supporting point. Then he will write like this, 1.2.1, and then he will write the supporting point. Supporting point means to clarify the subheading. 1.2.1, it means this supporting point is for the subheading number 1.2. And you can add heading number 2, heading number 3, heading number 4, and heading number 5. And at the end of the note, you have to mention key to abbreviation in a box. Whatever abbreviations, short forms you have used in your note, then all those abbreviations should be mentioned here in this box. Okay, in the format number 2, you can write like this, that title, number 1, the heading, and if you have to supply, if you have to add subheading, then you can mention here like this, A, then the points of subheading. Suppose you have to add supporting points to this subheading, then what you will do, you can write like this, leave that much space, okay, then you can use Roman numerals, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, then this subheading part is completed. If you have to add more subheading to the heading number 1, then you can write like this, subheading number A, subheading B, subheading C, and so on. And at the end, you have to provide key abbreviation. For example, a passage on heading is given, and the writer has made the note on the basis of his reading. So what he has done, he put the suitable title to his note, then on the basis of his reading, he divided the passage into two parts. Number 1, identification part, number 2 is the symptom part. Now, what he has done? He started writing like this. Instead of writing numbers, he used letters A and B. In the A part, he mentioned identification. By identification, he meant the types of heading. So in the identification part, he has to add subheading. So what he has done? Identification and the types of heading. Tension heading, migraine heading. Okay. In the next heading, he has to mention the symptoms. So he has written B, the symptoms part. Okay. He has to mention the symptoms of the tension headache as well as the migraine headache. So he has to rewrite the this point, tension headache. For tension, he used the letters TNSN, tension headache. Feeling symptoms, feeling tight band around head. Supporting point number 2, A and B, neck and shoulder pain. Okay. Sub point number 2, migraine headache. To support this subheading, he has to mention the symptoms. So he mentioned the symptoms like in the column A and B. A, pain on one side of head. B, vomiting and irritability. For the sake of convenience, he used the short form of two words. For tension, he used TNSN. And for migraine, he mentioned TNSN. So at the end of the note, he has to supply abbreviations used in the note. So what he did, he made a box and provided the abbreviations used. For him, TNSN means tension, MGRN means migraine. For the writer, these are not universal terms. This is for the end user of this note making. This is all for the day. Thank you.